These 7 Galaxy phones from Samsung were all released in the last year and a half with 7 different chipsets. The S24 FE and A56 are more in the mid-range segment. The S25 Ultra is the flagship phone of Samsung, and the Z Flip 7 is the latest flip phone. We also have 3 smaller phones, the S25, S24 Exynos, and S24 Snapdragon. IMO, and I decided to compare the battery life of these phones with each other. I did make sure all phones have the same brightness level using a lux meter, but since the tests are heavy, sometimes the phones throttle and dim their screen. All of them are connected to the same Wi-Fi network since I don't have 7 SIM cards. The S24 FE has 4,700, the A56 and S25 Ultra have 5,000, the Z Flip has 4,300, and the S25 and S24 both have 4,000 mAh batteries. I don't want to skew the results of the battery test too much, so before we start running apps, I'm going to run only a couple of short benchmarks. The first one is the Geekbench test. Here, the Galaxy S25 Ultra got the best score, which is not surprising since it is using the best chipset out here, which is the Snapdragon 8 Elite. Looking at the single core scores, the S25 Ultra is on top, followed by the S25, which is using the same chipset but is smaller. Then S24 Snapdragon, followed by S24 Exynos, S24 FE, and surprisingly, the Z Flip 7 is below them all. But when we switch to the multi-core, things change. The S25 Ultra is still on top, but the Z Flip 7 is third after the Galaxy S25. Generally, flip phones, regardless of brand and chipsets, cannot compete with other phones since the whole brain part of them is within the top half, and since they are also thinner, it means they have very little room for heat dissipation. For the next benchmark, I did only 1 minute of the 3D Mark test, which is a loop simulating playing 3D games. Here, not surprisingly, the S25 Ultra again got the best score, with A56 coming last. Looking at the chart, all 3 Snapdragon phones are on top, followed by the 3 Exynos phones. The Z Flip 7 is still doing a better job with Exynos 2500 compared to the S24 with Exynos 2400 and the S24 FE with Exynos 2400E. To make sure you get all the information needed, I also ran the application that I wrote to measure battery life, battery temperature in Celsius and Fahrenheit, and other metrics of the phones. It is always visible as a widget on the right side of the phone screen. I started the battery drain test by playing a YouTube live stream with the chat showing. This is a very easy test for all the phones since playing YouTube or any other media is not power consuming at all, especially for newer OLED displays. That's why you get these crazy screen on time numbers from some people if you spend your whole day reading Reddit and watching YouTube. It is similar to not using the phone at all compared to taking videos or making calls. I ran this test for around 2 hours, and another interesting observation was that both S24s were the coolest phones, probably because they don't have to fire as much real estate as the other phones. The Z Flip 7 was the hottest, but that's to be expected since the phone, as I mentioned, has a special form factor, making it impossible to do effective heat dissipation. After around 2 hours of playing YouTube, the S24 FE was at 85%, the A56 at 88%, the S25 Ultra at 84%, the Z Flip 7 at 84%, the S25 and S24 Exynos at 85%, and the S24 Snapdragon at 84% battery left. For the next test, I ran Aquarium, which is written in WebGL, on Google Chrome on all phones. Despite the unassuming look of the application, it is rather heavy since the phone has to render the fish. I also set the number of fish to 500, so all phones would run at 60 frames per second without any problem. This test is more heavy on the GPU side. This time, all phones had similar temperatures. They were all at 34 to 35 degrees Celsius, which is 94 to 95 degrees Fahrenheit. That was interesting since I expected some phones to get hotter than the rest. By the end of this part of the test, the A56 was ahead of the others with 83%, while the rest were at 79 to 80% battery left. I then decided to record with the selfie camera in 4K and 30 frames per second. Making videos is also a demanding task, and I should also say that generally these demanding tasks are going to favor the Galaxy A56 since its chipset runs less aggressively. You are, in exchange, going to get worse video quality since the phone won't process the video as much as the others, but it also means you get better battery life running the same task. It was not surprising that the three smaller phones went above 40 degrees Celsius, which is 104 degrees Fahrenheit first. By the end of the test, all phones were above 43 degrees Celsius, which is 108 degrees Fahrenheit, and were thermal throttling, except the Galaxy A56. That's one of the reasons I recommend getting the Galaxy A series phone in warmer climates, because the phones tend to get less hot due to the weaker processor. By the end of the test, there is a bigger difference between the phones now, but the Galaxy A56 is still on top. What's interesting is that the Z Flip 7 actually has a better battery percentage compared to the S25 Ultra, despite having a massively smaller battery capacity. All of these phones are only being used for testing purposes, and none of them are my personal phones, so the batteries shouldn't degrade that much over time. For the next test, I run YouTube Shorts. It is already midnight, and sometimes I stay awake until 1 or 2 to finish the test. If you want to make me motivated to continue doing so, you can like the video and subscribe to the channel. I run the short video of growing ananas, one of my favorite influencers. Write down in the comments if you have a favorite one. This is basically a video playback test since the phones just catch the video once and play it over and over again. As I mentioned, it is a very easy test for the phones. I then turned off the phones and went to sleep. When I woke up, the S25 Ultra and A56 were on top with 46% battery left, and at the bottom was the Galaxy S24 Exynos with 34% battery left. Surprisingly, the Z Flip 7 is going strong and doing better than the S24 FE. I then ran the heavy test of phones talking to each other over Google Meet. This is one of the most demanding tests you can do since the phones have to upload and download at the same time while encoding and decoding video. Generally speaking, so far I'm very impressed by the battery life and efficiency of the Z Flip 7. To an extent, it is related to having less power and also the screen resolution being lower than the S25 Ultra. Note that even if we lower the resolution of S25 Ultra in the settings, the phone still needs to fire up the hardware and the LEDs in the screen, so that wouldn't be a huge help. Plus, you are downgrading the screen. Just as a side note, all phones are running at their default screen resolution. I then decided to keep all phones connected to Google Meet, but also run the YouTube live stream in the background to make the test more intense and also more interesting. It does seem like the Galaxy S24 Exynos is going to be the first leaving the chat. But surprisingly, the S25 is also not doing much better. I've had very mixed results with the S25 so far. Sometimes I get good battery life and sometimes not. The S24 Exynos left the chat after 8 hours and 70 minutes as the first phone. After only a few minutes, the S25 also joined it at 8 hours and 26 minutes. The Galaxy S24 Snapdragon did surprise us by doing even better than the S25. Considering the phone is 1 year older and probably lost a couple of battery percentage points because of that, it is an amazing result. Now, the four titans are standing, and there's a close combat between the Z Flip 7 and the S25 Ultra. The Z Flip 7 heavily dimmed the screen though, and that gives it a slight advantage too. The next phone to go down was the S24 FE after 9 hours and 6 minutes. I was a bit surprised that the phone lasted less than the Z Flip 7, but the Z Flip is really surprising us here. It went shoulder to shoulder with the S25 Ultra, but while the Ultra had 1% battery left, the Z Flip 7 left the chat after 9 hours and 26 minutes, only 2 minutes before the S25 Ultra also left the chat. The only phone standing is the Galaxy A56. The A-series phones can't be directly compared to the S-series phones since the chipset is weaker and not as power hungry. Also, they don't offer the same performance and don't process photos and videos as much, which leads to lower quality but also better battery life. But with all that said, you should ask yourself whether you really need the performance of a flagship phone, or if you'd rather have the thermals and battery life of the A-series one. The Galaxy A56 became the king of 2025 Samsung battery test and left the chat after 10 hours and 11 minutes. Looking at the final chart of the battery life ranking in minutes, the A56 came first, and the S25 Ultra, together with the Z Flip 7, were close seconds. The S24 FE was fourth, while the smaller phones all had similar results. With one surprise, the OG S24 Snapdragon got a better result than the S25. If you want to see more of this kind of test, I did a thorough comparison of the new Exynos 2500 chipset versus other chipsets, including the Snapdragon 8 Elite, in a video you can watch next. Thanks for tuning into Techmo, and I will see you in the next one.